Hey, everybody, what's up with that freaking light? Where am I going to go? Oh, my God, I'm surrounded by light. Hey, everybody, how are you? It's Jeff. Jeff Gellman, Sally Canine Training, but you knew that because you're here. And we just got this dog in, nervous, fearful, anxious, dog reactive, and he bites?
Bites dogs.
He bites dogs. So, this is a dog also that's super sensitive. That's super sensitive to any leash pressure. What I mean by that is it's never a leash, it's never the type of collar that matters. It could be a martingale, it could be a slip lead, it could be a flat buckle. You know, what you're gonna see is you see dogs that just go, ah, the world's coming to an end. And the reason why they do that is because they just don't like the lack of free movement. That's what it boils down to. They're just like, I just wanna hang out here. Nah, you gotta go this way. Ah! And then usually owners go, okay, I won't push it. So what are we normally doing? So many times, and we're gonna do some Q&A. We're gonna do some Q&A after this, but I'm gonna have Claire, which is right there. She's gonna hold the camera. By the way, Claire is new.
Hello, everybody.
Nick is new.
Hi, everybody.
Claire, starting in the first week of June, we're doing puppy classes, puppy socialization, nose work 101, and then also we're bringing back our trick training, and then also Nick and Kristen are going to be doing pack walks on Saturday mornings again. So that'll all be up on the website very, very soon. So what do we do on day one? Let me show you. Just want to box them up? Box them up. All I'm going to do is sort of, which is different. A lot of times when we get this, when we get in a pushy, snotty dog, hey, Texas, hey, Matt, love you, buddy. When we get a pushy, snotty dog, it's like, nope, boundaries. Like, you know, you stop at every threshold, in and out of your crate a certain way. Oh, you can put the leash right back on. Yep. Yeah, I just want to like demo like what we would do. But this is also a dog that didn't want to come out of its kennel. So we're structured but unstructured. So I'm going to show you a typical protocol we do with a dog that's not human aggressive, that's not real pushy, because he's with us for 5 weeks because he's dog aggressive. So I'm going to show you what we're going to do to work the dog on day one. This is day two. So here we go. And here we go.
Claire, is this the first time you've held the camera with me?
Yep.
Okay, if I make you laugh, be a fucking professional, because when you laugh, the camera shakes. So you can't, you can laugh from the inside, but I'll try to be. So this is the dog right here. Gus, he takes only his own food?
Mm-hmm.
Is this his food right here?
Yeah.
So I've never handled a dog before. I didn't even know his name. If you haven't noticed, I'm not actually actively training dogs here. On a daily basis anymore. I got 25 seminars that I'm doing around North America this year, and I'm running the company, and I finally got this awesome staff that just like can do all this stuff for me. So, this is Gus. No matter what the dog is here for though, and so why is he in a crate inside of a crate? Because he demonstrates a magic trick as well. He'll be going into a straitjacket, suspended upside down over a 55 gallon bucket of water. That is on day three. So what we're gonna do is this. No matter what, why you're here, you still can't rush out of thresholds. So, you know, even if he's trying to be pushy, snotty there, we'll stop that. And we'll say, break. Okay, so this is a dog that if I would apply any leash pressure to, not just a prong, but this is a dog that's like, it feels anything, you know, any pressure, it goes, the end of the world is coming. So what do we do with a dog like that? I'm like, you know what? Let's just hang out. Let's walk around and smell the roses today. So, there is a little bit of control on my part. So for instance, let's just go this way. I'm gonna give him so much leash right now. And I'm just walking this way. Let's go this way. Hey, let's go this way. Look at that, buddy, that's so good. Look at you, superstar. Hey, let's go this way. And maybe you'll do that, good. And then maybe I'll go like this, and then maybe I'll go like that. There you go, buddy. I'm not telling the dog to sit, I'm not telling the dog to heel, here's a great example. These are place boards, but I'm not gonna say place. He's already been through a boarding training, correct? Mm-hmm. So he's already been through training somewhere else, which is fine. You see a lot of those dogs, it's no big deal, it's not a diss on them. Then what we're gonna do, and he keeps looking at me, good. You see me now? Good. Yeah, we just, again, I'm not being demanding on the dog. I'm just trying to put low pressure on this guy. And then let's go. We just go like this. And look, there's a place pad here. Are you gonna get on top of it? No big deal. I'm not gonna tell him wrong. I'm not gonna say place. I'm just be like, good. Well, wonderful. Climbing over stuff. All your puppies you should be doing this with, all your nervous, fearful dogs you should be doing this with on day one and day two. I assure you, here's the Bosu ball. Look at this. Can you climb up on that? No problem at all. It's not like, oh, Jeff, oh, good. It's not like, oh, you have to win every time. It's not like that at all. Things like this. What do you think about this? Let's go. Let's see what we got over here. A little bit of pressure there. Nope. No problem at all. Gonna walk away. It's not that the dog has to do this stuff today. We will get there. We'll get there. Here's another thing to climb on top of. How about over here? Let's go over here. What do you think of this? Good. Can we get you another level? No, no problem at all. Oh, yeah, there's food up there. So directional changes are big, like this. Let's go. Good job. Let's go this way. There we go. And we'll walk over a couple things. Good job. Go over here. Let's walk over this. Good job. Maybe you'll default into that. Good. You'll default into that. There you go. That's all I really care about right now. Low pressure. I'm not demanding. I'm sort of accepting half-assery, which is fine. Don't worry. We're, like, the big picture, we're not going to accept that casualness. But right now, you know, that's what I'm going to do with the dog. And it's a lot less pressure than being like, you have to sit, you have to down, you have to place. You have to walk exactly at my side. Now you can't jump up on me. So he has been corrected for barking, correct? So for barking and any whining in the crate. So he has been corrected for barking in the crate, whining in the crate. If he tried to rush out of his kennel, he would be corrected for that. But we're not gonna be like, and obviously if he tried to go after another dog, we would correct him for that. But right now, we're just gonna do this like casualness. It's just like, you know what? Hang out. Let's have a little bit of fun. We're not gonna play with him, but we're just gonna just do what we just did now. And he'll probably do that twice today. And has he been for a structured walk yet, or is it too soon? Hasn't gone off property for a structured walk yet. We're usually not in a rush to do that, by the way. Some dogs don't go for a structured walk till week two because they need to work on their fundamentals. Like, let's see, massively leash reactive to cars, people, and dogs. Sound sensitive to everything. Oh, let's go for a walk today. No. Let's work on some foundational things first. Understand the rules, absolutely understand some consequences, learn proper positioning. Then you know what? The thing you're doing the worst at, let's get you out there and let's work through those. The cool part is we have a training center. We can you know, walk dogs around. Now, if you're at your house, what do you do? Driveway, backyard, no rush. If you're an at-home trainer for my fellow colleagues out there, what do? Stay in the on this colleague's property. Or if you're doing a boarding train out of your house, maybe stay on your property. But don't feel like you've got to rush out to the worst thing and conquer that first. So safety things, you absolutely address right away. But a lot of the other stuff, like he just came off of that, I don't care. This will look different soon. But right now, no problem at all. All right. I'll do a little bit of Q&A. Claire's gonna take the dog. And da-da-da, turn you around.
Any quick questions for me at all? What's that? Oh, Linda is? Oh, hey, Linda. How are you? Oh, you're like, the mic is turned around. I gotta turn the mic around now. shit. I'm using a tripod that has my mic on it because we're trying something new. The free dog training, I make your day. Well, that's not good. We gotta get some more. We gotta get more excitement. Hey, Kim, love you too. Hey, Roddy, Scotland, how are you? Hey, Roddy, yeah, it's been a long time since I've been doing lives. This is unique. What do you guys think of this wall? Did you paint this wall, Nick? So, Nick, just started working here 2 weeks ago. Close your ears, Nick. Just close your ears. He's fucking been killing it here. So excited for him. He's one of these guys that does, like, a little bit of everything. A little bit of everything. You guys need walls done? Plumbing, no. Electricity, no. I doubt he's going to re-roof this place. And he's probably not going to do any masonry. But, like, just getting shit done as well as dog skills. As well as dog skills. So, his next big project, swimming pool. Getting that set up. All right? And he's also going to be doing the pack walks on Saturday. You'll be able to see him on Saturday. And you'll probably, if you do our daycare and our boarding, you probably have seen him bring your dog in and bring your dog out. And then he's obviously going to also start doing some training of dogs here as well. All right. What else do we got? He usually is caught, let's see. And don't forget, tonight at 8:30 p.m. Eastern time, I have the Q&A on YouTube Live. There's a link on today's, what are we on here? I'm on Facebook. On Facebook, in the feed, there's a link to it, but you can also find it in our YouTube, description, in our feed there. There's a link. Sean told us to check out your bonking videos and fixed our dog barking at the window. Thanks. You're welcome. Yeah, bonking is one of the best things to stop an unwanted behavior. I got 3 videos on YouTube for that. Hey, Freddie, Copper City, what's going on? Matt Morris, Texas is in the house. I heard the gunshots from here. Love you, buddy. All right. Hey, everybody. Dylan, much respect. Thanks for helping dogs that post people, that past people won't. Oh, well, that, you know, there's a lot of good people out there trying. A lot of good people out there trying. Cannon says hello. Jennifer, you got one? Yep, you did. Let's see. I need to send my girl to you. She's so sweet, but dog aggressive, high prey drive. So this is the first thing. So Allison, start out by, first go to jeffgelmanseminars.com. Go to jeffgelmanseminars.com and start there. See if there's a seminar by you. Go to the seminar. And then what you can also do is you can do a Skype session with me. Watch all my free videos. But obviously we're a business. Like, we need dogs to be coming in here. So that we need. So feel free to obviously, you know, look into that. And if you want to do a board and train, you which with your dog aggressive dogs, people aggressive dogs, it's hard to do it on your own. Massive separation anxiety. It's really, really hard to do it on your own. So let's just check out the rates for that. Right now we've got about a 5-6 week wait list. And you fill out a contact form and I'll get back to you. All right. Michelle, our number one commenter on YouTube. Hi, how are you? Hey, Seattle. Seattle, I'll be back in December, I think. I'm going to be back there. I think December. Hawaii is November. Yep, it is. It's December. We switched to December. Roddy, I want to be in the UK, Roddy, 2020. So I'm more than happy to come to Scotland if you want to arrange a seminar in Scotland for 2020, and I absolutely want to be in England somewhere. So we need to find a secure, if you have any new contacts, Roddy, in England, I love a secure site where we're not going to get everything mucked up like last time. That would be great. Roddy, if anybody's over in the UK, look up Roddy Kirk. Roddy Kirk, he's a fantastic trainer over there. Nice new colors, yep. Gina, okay. Kenneth, how are you? Glad you got your notification. Swimming videos. I know, Tara, swimming videos start, theoretically I can swim them now, today. The pool looks like shit. So today I've got to get new brushes to brush the inside. I still got to vacuum it out. The water, though, is looking fantastic. All right. I'm going to be in Chicago. Coming up. I'm also in Elkhart, Indiana next weekend. So Chicago is going to be a I forgot when it's coming up. What do I do if a dog pulls hard on the leash? You correct it hard. You correct it hard. Yeah. So if a dog is leash, if you've got a leash reactive dog or a big puller, you correct that. Like, if this dog would have pulled around the training center, I would have corrected him. But I don't need to because the way I was moving. So the energy that I was doing, the way I was moving, I didn't need to do that stuff. That's the goal of all this stuff, is you're just getting your dog into like these low pressure situations. Susie, I used to do Facebook Lives daily. I know. I don't want to say I've stopped, but also, this is before we were doing all this other content on Facebook. I'm loving this wall for lives.
Right?
This is really nice here. What are we doing with these guys?
I think they're
going to
get hung up on those pillars.
On the pillars or over the window where it's wood? Yeah, because it's wood there. Give that a shot. But then again, it's up pretty high, though. Yep. Yes, you bought Jessica. Yes, you bought. So I can't bonk a dog on camera. I will one day. Put it this way. I do it in my seminars. They're all videotaped. Yeah, you don't bonk the floor. You bonk the dog extremely hard. Yes. People... The snowflakes go nuts at bonking videos. Even my colleagues in the balance training community, they've considered abusive, which I find ironic because we're using electronic collars. So it's like, really? It's a cotton towel. Doesn't hurt the dog. Anybody that's claiming that bonkers hurt dogs is just not, I don't know. It just doesn't make sense to me. I've never seen one. Gary Wilkes, who's probably bonked 10,000 dogs, he's never seen one. Like, we're not seeing dogs hurt by towels. We're just not. You and Falcon. Oh, Anastasia, good. Falcon. Oh, good. Proud of you. Good. But John, the first week we don't do bonding. We do that for maybe one day. And John, that's specifically for a dog like this. Pushy, snotty dogs are different. But we don't have a week to bond. But you have to be really careful about bonding doesn't mean over-affection. So as long as you realize what bonding means, over-affection will work against you. So I'm still, theoretically, I was in control. So it looked like the dog might have been controlling the situation, but I was actually controlling the situation. So I was just being really subtle with the dog. Roddy, yes, brother, sort it out. We can arrange both together. Awesome, Roddy. Let's do it. 2020, I'll be there. Thanks, Jennifer, for sending people my way. You're welcome, Gene. I'm just going through all the comments. Rhonda, you've got a problem between balancing drill sergeant and to be affectionate with my dogs. So this is it. There's a difference between a leader and a boss. Rhonda, be a leader. And leaders have empathy, compassion, hold people accountable, hold dogs accountable, rules, structure. That's what a leader is. A boss, you're pretty dickish most of the time. Got it? Gina, do they differentiate between people and dogs? Oh no, different species. There's a difference between dog-dog aggression and dog-human aggression. Like, we work with dog killers that are like, they'll sleep with cats. They'll sleep with chickens. They see a dog, they want to kill it. Humans, kids, babies, they're fine with. So we see it. And then we see dogs that are aggressive towards everything. All right, guys, I'm going to get going. And if you've got questions, more questions, just jump on my YouTube Live. Jump on my YouTube Live, all right? And take care. Bye.